climate change, and I have. So let me tell you what happened within the meeting. So you know, I have a story, and then I apologize. I do apologize, but I said I'll try not to have a guest. Somebody just called me out of the person and said, please, should you? And they started whining and massing my head. So I said, okay, it's a good romance anyway, so let's see how we can talk about it then. So what happened? I was in this bush, and originally I was going forward, and then I saw a young girl who, her name is Greta Thunberg, and she was really talking, and she was very angry talking to the leaders about climate change. The next call I get is from somebody that says, oh, we'd like to talk about climate change, and I said, okay, no problem. Let's just get to it. So this morning we're looking at climate change, fighting climate change. But it has a twist to it. It has two brothers who are using, I sang and probably Shade has talked to them that they don't use water when they wash people's cars. But that's like the issue of this conversation. This morning we'll be looking at two people who decided that they want to. Let me read their profile to you. One is the co-founder of Autosparkle, a unique company that focuses on extreme care for the interior of cars using a waterless detailing approach. Okay, he's a computer science graduate from Unilag with over 7 years of experience as a digital marketing professional. He's also a certified e-business professional in customer relations management, and the rest is history. Right, the second one, who has 13 plus years of entrepreneurial experience and 2 years plus of working on a wide array of both local and international brands, primarily developing brand communication strategy and content. The rest again is history. But so it was my classmate in Orange Academy, and it's one less too much in this life. The second one, so but hey. I have with me Genesis and Jesse Onomiwo. Welcome to Signals.
Thank you, Shady. Thank you for having us
today. For my life. Okay, so we're talking climate change, and it poses a serious global challenge, and Nigeria is not left out of this tender negative impact. So let's talk about climate change before we now get to the nitty gritty of what you know about the innovation you have actually.
Thank you, Oshidi, for having us today on the show. I'd like to say that the issue of climate change is a very critical one that we tend to wish away and feel that it's something that is not real, but it is real. Considering the fact that by 2030, about 700 million people would be displaced by intense water scarcity. Now, that's a big problem. Currently, as we speak, there are about 2 billion people across the world that are experiencing continuous high water stress, especially women and children. The effects of climate change, you know, are very devastating, from drought to floods and all whatnot that we're talking about in the course of this program today. So I believe that people need to be aware about the danger and that is looming as a result of climate change, and what we need to do to be able to abat, you know, the negative challenges of climate change.
Is it really affecting us here in Nigeria?
Oh, it's really affecting us. If you stay on the island, for example, you must have heard of the frequent flood occasions when it rains and everything.
So this does not have to do with the drainage. Does it have to do with that?
It has to do with it, but that's not the primary cause. It's not the primary cause.
It's not the primary cause. Okay, now, this discussion has been on and on and on. But we have a lot of car wash around, and everybody's using water. And I realize that there's a lot of wastewater. Like, generally, wastewater. We like water. And then I read an article where very soon we don't have water again. Is that going to happen anytime soon?
So the truth of the matter is, this is a reality in other parts of the world already, you know, where there's shortage of water. There are some countries right now that even by legislation, you are not allowed to wash cars with water.
Okay.
And some time ago in California, like the residents decided that for a whole month they were not going to wash their cars with water, you know, to tell you that people are actually waking up to this fact that, you know, our resources are depleting and what can we do about it? I mean, an average car wash takes over 450 liters of water, you know, to get the car cleaned properly. So this is something that, whether no matter how we look at it, it has an impact. From, you know, our daily activities, washing our cars, using water, has an impact on the general availability of water in the world.
But, you know, without water, we're not. We need water now. We need water every day. How do we now?
Exactly. So the thing is, there is a battle between choosing what you use water for in terms of. Okay, so water should be left for things that, you know, are very critical. Like car washing is critical here, but if we could find other ways to, you know, clean our cars without using such amount of water, washing a car per time, then we should explore.
So tell us what you've done with not using water.
Okay, so we actually started out as a waterless car wash somewhere in Victoria and Lagos. Would go serve some of our clients, mostly bankers back then. We're busy. We try to fuse that sustainability approach with providing convenience. So we have it's basically based on nanotechnology. Nanotechnology is a science that is applied in various ways. Now, the way it's applied here is such that we have these special cleaning agents that have the capacity to work on dirt. You know, they have the power to work on dirt. They wicken the dirt. And then by the time we use some special materials to rub off the dirt, it's not having an impact on the surface of the paint, for instance, in case of exterior cleaning. Now, that way, we don't have to use water anymore.
So you don't use water
at all. We can wash a car without
your
using water.
A whole dirty car. Dirty car.
We have done it. Yes.
So now, between the both of you, who came up with the idea? How did it start? Tell us, run us through that story.
Okay, actually, I came up with the idea.
Okay.
So we met this lawyer in 2005. I had just finished secondary school then, and we heard a lot about him, his dedication to life and everything. His barrister Taiwo Polati, who is listening in from South Korea right now. His principle and way of life so much inspired us that he gave us a book, and that book changed the game for us. I read that book 2 times. Jesse read the book as well. And one day I was walking by the road and it was rainy season. I saw cars passing by the road. They were dirty and everything. And within me, I felt most of the people in those cars were office workers and no time for, you know, a lot of things in life, including washing their cars. So I thought, why not come up with an idea that takes car wash to people's offices? So we started the mobile car wash business back in 2010. In the process of delivering our services, we realized that there were challenges with getting water to use and everything. So we started thinking. I'd read a lot of books on innovating in business, you know, coming up with solutions to problems and everything. So I thought that there has to be a way, you know, to wash the cars of these guys without having to depend on them for water. That was the moment that the quest started, and then the big idea came in. So we started making research and everything. Even before we knew that it was possible, we started affirming, we started, you know, saying it, that we're going to do it, we're going to make it happen, and we did.
So whose first car did you use to try this?
The first car we used to try this was the car of a young lady used to work in one of the banks in those days. Yes, she was curious when we sold the idea to her, and she wanted to see.
So was it Toyota Corolla?
Wait, don't pay me. Don't call them cars. Okay, and now, so I'm running. missing?
It holds a lot of challenges.
Did people believe you? Did they give you their cars? Because, hey, when in Nigeria, whereby it's easy for people to believe things, right? You find a little bit of people, a few people would want to take a chance. So that's why I'm asking, waterless, no water, my car will be neat.
Yeah. I mean, we had a few young guys, young professionals who gave us a chance in one of the bands. I didn't talk about them. They experienced the service for the first time and they were wild. Like, really?
See why I'm excited.
I'm telling you. Because, the way it came across was like the first time we cleaned inside and outside of their cars. And when they discovered that outside of the cars, we washed the cars and at the same time it was waxed and the shine was superior. We're like, really? How what's this? You know, they began to spread the word themselves. Of course, we had the challenge of pricing because in Nigeria,
your big guy helping you to wash your car.
Free of charge, or just 100 naira.
200 naira, 1,000 naira.
You know, we came in there, we're saying we wanted to charge
even you.
500 naira or something. I think
Genesis, we have to